Good morning, my lovely kids. Hope you are doing good with your health as well as in your studies. Today we will start our class with one more interesting lesson, that is lesson number 24, At the Market. Children, as you are familiar with many common places around you, among them a common place is a market. Market is a place where you can see many people with different conversation. Look at the following pictures. Read the conversations given on the opposite page. Then match the conversations and the picture by using them appropriate number. Lesson number 24, At the Market. In the first picture, there are two peoples. Let's find out their conversation. A. Hello, uncle. Mother has sent this list of grocery items for the month. Can you deliver them today? B. Sure, we will deliver them today. In the second picture, there are two kids with their grandfather and a man selling bubble maker. A. Grandpa, the bubbles look so lovely. Can we buy the bubble maker? B. Why not? Let's buy 3. 2 for you children and 1 for me. In the third picture, a mother is sitting in a juice shop with her son. A. Please give us 2 full glasses and don't put ice in the juice. B. But mama, I want some ice in my juice. A. Okay, put only a little ice in each glass. In the fourth picture, two ladies are talking about a cake shop. A. Have you tried these cakes? They are so delicious. B. This is a new cake shop, is it? But I am not very fond of cakes. In the fifth picture, a person is selling corn and two people are making their conversation. A. Do you like roasted corn cobs? B. Oh, I love them with salt and lemon juice. A. Let's see at what price he is selling them. In the sixth picture, an old woman and a shopkeeper are making their conversation. A. Good morning, Ajji. How can I help you? B. I want to buy rice for the whole year. Show me the varieties you have and tell me the prices. A. Ajji, this variety is good. Don't worry about the price. It is not very costly. Let's find out what conversation is going on in the seventh picture. A. Give me some tomatoes. B. Where's your bag? A. I don't have one. Give me a plastic carry bag. B. Sorry, I don't keep plastic bags. In the eighth picture, conversation is different between a man and a woman. A. Here are your potatoes. Would you like to buy tomatoes? These are nice and fresh. B. Sure. Wait, I will give you another bag for the tomatoes. So children, how was the lesson? Hope you enjoyed the lesson as well as matching the pictures with their conversation. Children, you can also make your own conversation by seeing the pictures. Doing this, you will have fun. That is all for today. Take care of yourself. Thank you. Goodbye, kids. Good morning, kids. Here we are back with one more interesting lesson of our English class. That is lesson number 25, After School. Children, in our previous lesson, we have seen a common place, a market. This lesson is also similar to that. It's about a school. Kids, school is a place where you go every day and learn something good. The lesson expresses the feeling of children after spending the whole day in the school. So let's see how you feel after leaving school. Lesson number 25, After School. Although we like to go to school, we are rather glad to put away our books and slates and other things when it is over for the day. And off we go to play and romp, while teacher, who is good and kind, is left behind all by herself, but then perhaps she doesn't mind. Although we like to go to school, we are rather glad to put away our books and slates and other things when it is over for the day. And off we go to play and romp, while teacher, who is good and kind, is left behind all by herself, but then perhaps she doesn't mind. First stanza. Children, you like to go to school every day, and as the school is over, very happily you put all your belongings like books, pencil, tiffin and other things in your bag when the final bell rings and the school is over for the day. Second stanza. When the school is over and you leave the school in a very happy way, the person who is left behind in the school, that is your teacher, who is very kind and good. As you all leave the school first, she is still there in the school. And after saying goodbye to all of you with a happy and a good mood, she leaves the school. Children, there are rhyming words in the poem. First stanza, away, day. Second stanza, kind, mind. Children, I know what you all are thinking. You all are just thinking about your teacher. How she lives in the school after you all are gone. I know you all are missing your school and your teacher very much. We too are missing you all. This is all for today. Take care of yourself. Goodbye.